So, the SHERLOC, I think it's the scanning habitable environments with Raman and luminescence for organics and chemicals. Is that? Hey, all right. So can you just tell me a little bit about what exactly the SHERLOC is?
Yes, of course. So SHERLOC is the arm-mounted deep ultraviolet Raman and fluorescent spectrometer. So it's one of the boxes that's attached to the very end of the robotic arm. The instrument itself is about the size of a cereal box. It incorporates the UV Raman fluorescent spectrometer, but it also has an attached camera called Watson, which is it's the camera that's responsible for taking, for example, the selfies. You know, they just released one the other day. It was the first official selfie of the entire rover. And the way they take that is, you know, they extend the robotic arm and then they rotate the arm so that the camera can capture a picture of every part of the rover, and then they stitch those all together. But SHERLOC itself, the spectrometer, is an imaging spectrometer. It's mounted to the arm so that we can extend it over and position the instrument over a rock of interest. So let's say that, you know, we're driving around Mars, you know, Jezero crater, we find a rock that is particularly interesting. The way we'll try to analyze what's there is we'll cut away some of the surface material using the drill just to expose like a fresh surface, probably like half a centimeter to a centimeter below the original surface. And then that fresh surface will hopefully have any like intact material that was left behind when the river and lake system that used to exist in Jezero dried up. We'll then shoot that rock with our UV laser that's part of the instrument, and we'll scan it across the rock surface, kind of like, you know, in a raster path, and we'll look at the light that comes back from the rock. So we're collecting Raman and fluorescence at the same time. So if you're not aware, Raman scattering is this phenomenon where, you know, you shoot a molecule with a very monochromatic light source. Some of that light gets scattered inelastically, so it comes back with a different energy to what you put in. And the change in energy corresponds to the excitation of particular kinds of vibrations in the molecule itself. So they occur at very specific energies. And if we look at those changes in energy, we see a pattern of peaks that correspond to the vibrational modes of a molecule. And it's extremely specific. It's actually sometimes referred to as the molecular fingerprint, because it's so specific to a molecule structure. So as we scan across the rock surface, we're looking for that Raman scattering. We're also looking for fluorescence. Fluorescence is like the, you know, direct emission of light from molecules that have absorbed the laser light and re-emitted it. And, you know, it's a classic kind of thing, you know, it's stuff like glows in the dark, that's a form of fluorescence. So what we're looking for is the fluorescence and Raman scattering of primarily of organic molecules. So the kind of molecules that could be the building blocks of life as we know it. We're looking for those kinds of signatures, and we're generating a spectral map of the surface that we're scanning so that we can kind of correlate the presence of any organic material to the presence of particular minerals or like bands and structure in the geological structure, so that we can build this, you know, clearer understanding of when did those molecules get introduced to these rocks? You know, what point in the geological history of Jezero crater did these molecules get trapped in these rocks and preserved over billions of years?